Hi, everybody. I am Michelle Gibson. I teach science at Montcalm Community College, and today we're going to talk about conductivity. Conductivity has to do with whether a molecule is ionic or covalent. An ionic molecule, when you put it in water, will disassociate into its ions. An ion is any atom with a charge, positive or negative. A covalent molecule will not break apart in water, will not disassociate because covalent bonds are much stronger than ionic bonds. So we're going to measure how well they conduct different things will conduct electricity in water, and you should be able to understand ahead of time that the more ionic the molecule is, or the more ions it releases into the solution, the more electricity that solution should carry. Okay, think of like a battery. The reason it works is it's conducting electricity between the positive and the negative nodes on your battery, and if you put a load in between, like a light bulb, the light bulb will light up. So we have a conductivity tester here, and basically you put the bottom of the machine into a solution and lights will light up depending on how conductive the solution is. So in this first beaker, we just have plain water. Plain water should not conduct electricity much at all, and you notice there are no lights whatsoever shining that light up when you put the conductivity tester in distilled water, because there shouldn't be any ions in that water. The next beaker, we have plain distilled water. We're gonna add a little bit of salt to. This is just regular table salt. You wanna swirl it around and mix it a little bit. When you put the conductivity tester in there, notice that it lights all the way up nearly to the top. Okay? I hit the top now that we're down there close to the salt, because sodium chloride, NaCl, splits into the sodium ion and the chloride ion in that water. Now before we go to another solution, we want to rinse off the conductivity tester, make sure the salt gets off of that before we put it in the next solution. So again, plain water, you should get no conductivity. Okay, that's a good way to rinse it as well. Now in this third beaker, we're going to add a little bit of sugar. And sugar, or glucose, hopefully you remember from your lecture that glucose is a covalently charged molecule. Even though it will dissolve in the water, the sugar molecules themselves don't actually come apart because it's covalently bonded, like the salt comes apart. So when you put this in here, again, you get pretty much no conductivity. Okay? And adding more sugar should not do anything for you, okay? Right? Because you just added more covalent molecules, and the water might have gotten a little sweeter if you drank it, but it shouldn't change conductivity, okay? All right, so once again, conductivity is based on the number of ions in the solution. So plain water, you should not get any conductivity. In salt water, you should get quite a bit of conductivity. Okay, and adding more salt, you should get more conductivity. We can't add any more because we're already at the top of our scale, so I added too much to begin with. Okay, so ionic molecules conduct electricity. So your job at home now is to figure out whether our unknowns number one and number two have ions in them, okay, and which one would have more ions. So let's put it in unknown number one. Okay, and you can see it's blinking at the fourth light up. Okay, so we do have some conductivity. What does that mean? Okay, you're going to be asked to explain that in your lab. All right, let's look at unknown number two. Again, we're going to rinse this off, make sure it's not contaminated from the first one. Put it in number two. Unknown number two. Doesn't look like it's lighting very much up there at all. I don't see a single light. So again, can you guess what kind of solution or what kind of molecule we put into that distilled water compared to unknown number one? Okay. So now you've learned a little bit about conductivity. Hopefully you can complete the lab.